welcome to the mathematics class. This class is for class 9 ICSE, and today we will be discussing about quadratic equations. Now let us say, first of all, what is a quadratic equation? So if I take a polynomial p in x, that is equal to 0. So this is known as quadratic equation. Now what is the meaning of polynomial x which is quadratic? Now polynomial x means a polynomial in which the highest power or exponent of variable x is 2. If I write x square minus 9 is equal to 0, so this is a quadratic equation. What is required? That the value, that the power of x, maximum power of x has to be 2. If I say x minus 9 is equal to 0, this is not a quadratic equation, this is a linear equation. Its general form is ax plus b is equal to 0. Similarly, suppose I write x square minus 6x plus 4 is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation, and its general equation is, or general formula is, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a, b and c are real numbers and x and a is never equal to 0. Why is it so? If a will be equal to 0, then something multiplied to 0 will be 0. It means this first term will be completely 0. If this first term will be 0, it means only two terms are left, bx plus c, where x square term is missing, or coefficient of x square, or you can say this term is missing. So it will not remain as a quadratic equation. Now we'll start with this. I'll tell you. Just now we studied that ax square plus bx plus c is the general quadratic equation or general form of quadratic equation. What is the meaning of this? Suppose I say x minus 9 is equal to 0. This is a linear equation. It means when you solve this equation, you will always get only one value of x. From this you can say implies that x is equal to 9. That's it. No other answer. Similarly, when you solve this equation, it is for sure that you will get at least two values of x. Let us say one value is alpha and other value is beta. Means whenever you will solve this equation, ax square plus bx plus c, you will always get two values of x. I have taken one value as alpha and other value as beta. Now what is the meaning of this? It means these are said to be the roots or solution. These values alpha and beta are said to be the roots of the quadratic equation or solution of the quadratic equation. Now what is the meaning of solution of the quadratic equation? Means when you substitute the values of x as alpha or beta in the given equation, these values must satisfy the equation. Suppose here I got the value of x as 9. Now if I substitute this value in this x, it means it should come 0. So you can see 9 minus 9 is equal to 0. Means the value of x is equal to 9 satisfies the equation. Satisfies means both right hand side and left hand side, or left hand side and right hand side are equal. Similarly in this, you can see if I put x as alpha in this equation, this whole value should come 0. Or I substitute beta in place of x, the value should come as 0. Let's take an example for this. Let's say an example, I'm taking it as x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. This I have taken an example to show or to find out the roots. Now we know that the solution of this equation will be x minus 1 into x minus 2 is equal to 0. After solving, in between it has been solved. After solving, I will tell you how to solve later on, but first we are on this concept, so I will describe this concept. Now it means x can be equal to 1 or x can be equal to 2. This is also one zero product rule. I will explain it to you. Zero product. Now if you substitute the value of x as 1 over here in this equation, you will get 1 square minus 3 into 1 plus 2 is equal to, so 2 and 1, 3 minus 3 is 0. Or you put 2 in this equation, so 2 square minus 3 into 2 plus 2. So 2 square is 4 minus 6 plus 2. 4 plus 2 is 6, minus 6 is 0. You can see that these values, or x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2, can be said as roots or solution of the given equation. Means when I have substituted either 1 or 2, the equation has been satisfied. Satisfied means left hand side is equal to the right hand side. Now I move on to the solution part. Now what is the, how to solve this? How to solve this equation and how to get the values or how to find out the roots? What is the general thing? It is in your syllabus, means in class 9 syllabus, it is only by factorization method. In factorization, you have studied a topic, splitting the middle term. You have already studied splitting the middle term. The middle term. So that is an expanded version. This equation is expanded version of splitting the middle term. How do we solve? V multiply A and C means A is multiplied to C to get AC. Now this AC is factorized. AC is factorized, and whatever are the factors, let's say P, Q, R, S, T, whatever are the factors, they are arranged in such a method so that either the sum or the difference of factors, sum or difference of factors is equal to B. What we do? We multiply A and C, then we factorize the product, that is AC, and whatever are the factors that are factorizing, they are arranged in such a method that their sum or difference should be equal to B. At the same time, their product should be AC along with the sign. If it is plus, it should be plus. If it is minus, it has to be minus. Now, let us take the previous question, that was x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. So what is the value of A over here? A is 1, B is minus 3, and C is 2. Now A and C are multiplied. A and C means 1 and 2 are multiplied, so you get product as 2. You have to factorize the product. So product is 2 into 1 is 2. Now these are the factors, 2 and 1 are the factors. They have to be arranged in such a way that either the sum or the difference should be equal to minus 3. So 3 can be written as 2 plus 1, means x square minus 3 can be written as 2 plus 1 into x. What we have done? We have utilized both these factors, 2 plus 1 and then plus 2 is equal to 0. Now what we will do? Open the bracket, x square minus 2x minus x plus 2 is equal to 0. Now from these we can take something common, from these we can take something common. So from these we can take x common, that is left, x minus 2 is left, then again minus 1 common, what is left? X minus 2 is left is equal to 0. From these you can take x minus 2 common, एक्स माइनस टू इंटू एक्स माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो. नाउ हेयर कम्स द प्रोडक्ट रूल. हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ स्टिल वी डोंट नो द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. सो वॉट वी विल डू, लेट्स सी ओवर हेयर वॉट आर वी गोइंग टू डू इन दिस. यू नो दैट इफ आई से a into b is equal to 0. To explain this, x minus 2 and x minus 1 is equal to 0. If I say a into b is equal to 0, it means either this is 0 or this is 0, or you can say both are 0. If product of two numbers equal to 0, it means either first number is 0 or the second number is 0, or it is also possible that both the numbers can be 0. So in this case, first I will take, let, this is known as zero product rule. This is known as zero product rule. So according to the zero product rule, we can say, let us assume that x minus 2 is equal to 0. If x minus 2 is equal to 0, it means x is equal to 2. If I say let x minus 1 is equal to 0, it means x is equal to 1. So you got two values of x that are going to, these values are going to satisfy this equation, and these are known as roots of the equation. In quadratic equation, what generally you have to solve in your syllabus is only to find out the roots of a quadratic equation. Now before I move on to the questions, let's discuss few questions whether you can actually find out that a given equation is a quadratic or not. So, I've taken few examples in which you have to find out which of the given are quadratic equations, and if they are quadratic equations, also find the roots of the quadratic equation. Means in these examples, I will try to cover up the whole concept. Now look at this first one, x square minus 6x plus 4. If you compare this with ax square plus bx plus c, you can easily make out that this equation is written in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 6, and c is equal to 4. It means this is a quadratic equation. So let's put a tick. We'll find out the roots of this equation later on. Anyway, or let's only stick to this one, that yes, this is a quadratic equation. Understood. Now, 2x square minus 7x can be written as ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. In this equation, a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 7, and c is equal to 0. Now in this equation, c is 0, but we know that an equation to be a quadratic equation, a should not be equal to 0, rest anything can be equal to 0. A should not be equal to 0, that is the most important thing. B and c can be equal to 0. So in the second one, you can see that a is 2, b is minus 7, but c is 0, no problem. This is also a quadratic equation. Next, x plus 3 upon x equal to x square. If you solve it out, you take the LCM, it will become x square plus 3 is equal to x cube. You take the LCM, LCM is x, this will be x square plus 3, and this x multiplied to x square, that becomes x cube. So, in this you can see that the maximum power of the variable x is 3. Which is not permissible. You cannot have the power more than 2. So this is not a quadratic equation. Understood? Now let's consider this. Now this you can see, if you take the LCM, it will become x to the power 4. Let's write x to the power 4 plus 1 is equal to 2x squared. Though this is not a quadratic equation in x, but this can be reduced to the quadratic equation. How? If I consider, let us say, let x square is equal to y. Let us substitute a value y in place of x square. So this can be written as y square plus 1 is equal to 2y. That can be later on written as y square minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0, which is in the form of a y square plus by plus c is equal to 0. So this equation is not a quadratic equation in x, but it can be reduced to a quadratic equation. So if the question is whether the given equation is a quadratic equation in x, no, it is not a quadratic equation in x. But if the question asks whether it is a quadratic equation, so yes, you can reduce it to the form of quadratic equation. Now look at this one. X square plus 2 root x means here the value or the power of x is 1 upon 2, which is nowhere written in the general form. 2, 1, 0. You can also understand this as a x square plus bx plus c into x to the power 0 is equal to 0. Anything to the power 0 is always 1. That is why it is written as ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Means x is the powers are written in decreasing 2, 1, 0. Now in this case it is 2, 1 upon 2 and then 0. So this is not in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Therefore, this is also not a, this is not a quadratic equation also. Now the last one. You can see that there are two equations given. Let us solve 3 minus 2 x square. Minus 4x plus 2x is minus 2x, and 2 minus 4 is minus 2 is equal to 0. Now you can see that this sixth equation is completely in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Hence, it is a quadratic equation. I hope by this time you would have been clear that how to make out whether a given equation is a quadratic equation or not. Now we try to solve out some questions. Question 6 plus x square to x square, you have to solve it. Solving means you have to find out the values of x. And it's for sure that there are always, in a quadratic equation, there are always two values of x. So first of all, we'll write it in a proper form. So these both, these things move to this side. Sorry. It can be written as x square minus x minus 6 is equal to 0. Now it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. What we do in this, we know that value of a is 1, b is minus 1 and c is minus 6. What we do, we multiply a and c, means we will take minus 6. Minus I am writing else, and because we need to factorize 6, so factors of 6 are 2 into 3. Let's take 2 into 3. Now these factors are to be arranged in this way so that we should get minus 1. So 3 minus 2, or this can be written as x square minus minus x. So this will be written as 3 minus 2. 3 into minus 2 is minus 6. So product is also you are getting as minus 6. And 3 minus 2 and minus of this you will get as minus 1. Minus 6 is equal to 0. So x square, when you open the bracket, will be minus 3x and plus 2x. Minus 6 is equal to 0. From this we can take x common. What is left? X minus 3 plus 2 common. X minus 3 is equal to 0. From these we can take x minus 3 common. So what is left? X plus 2 is equal to 0. When x minus 3 is equal to 0, x will be equal to 3. And when x plus 2 is equal to 0, x will be equal to minus 2. So these are the roots of this quadratic equation. If you want to verify, you can verify also. X square minus x minus 6 equal to 0. I am taking x equal to 3. So 3 square minus 3 minus 6 So 9 minus 3 minus 6, so 9 minus 9 is equal to 0. And when x is equal to minus 2, so minus 2 square minus of minus 2 minus 6, so minus 2 square is 4, and this minus minus plus and minus 6, so 6 minus 6 equal to 0. So in both the cases you can see that the roots are satisfying the equation. It means our solution has been right. So I am ending my class. I expect everybody to go through this at least twice so that your concept should be clear. And now we'll be moving on to exercise 7. I think there are 12 questions, so we'll be doing in the multiples of 2. Wait for the next class and please like, subscribe and share. Thank you.